teams that are now on the ground and doing everything possible to solve these matters. But apart from that, we have redeployed many of our policing into these areas to stabilize the areas. As you know, that the resources we have, we've got to use them equitably and go into stabilization and go elsewhere. So we redeployed many members into this area and called others that were on rest days to come and supplement policing in Khayelitsha and in Nyanga.
A mere 10 years old baby boy only wanted it was a haircut. He was a happy child. He was doing great too at Nolungile Primary School. And he was the only child. It was my sister's only child.
Just imagine kubulawe imveku ezingaka. Kuba nakula Barbershop ekulela abantwana babantu eleli phezu kwegasi. Kulwe naye esiza wabelandela uEnzo. UEnzo kula khona uyo waphansi waphakama ezama ubaleka ukuza ngasendlini waphinda wazowela pha ngasecaweni ndibona uba udisi. Okwesithathu uthe xa isithi ndabe sendikhwazi umamakhe ndathi izawuenza udutyula ubomvu kusiphatha kabuhlungu esingaziyo into yokokuba ngaba konakele phi uthixo phi.
They have all the state of the art equipment in terms of looking for weapons. Why they don't deploy such state of the art equipment in this area so that we can eradicate all these guns? There's always excuses. We sit in meetings where people plan, no implementation. PCs here, Major General here, our cry to them, we always say, stop being in the boardroom. Let's start being on the ground. There's no intelligence, my brother. Because intelligence supposed to see these things prior. All of a sudden now, SAPS is always reactional. What happened to proactive approach? We've been pleading with the minister. What happens? The proactive approach. Why must we always come at the crime scene always?